you just yell at me, so I make sure.
Imagine. I went work in the toothpaste factory one day.
Let's help him out, Charlie.
What kind of positive thinking is that? Charlie's been working for Mr. Wonka, making chocolate bars.
Now, Grandpa Joe, don't go filling the boy's head with dreams of candy.
Charlie comes from a long line of distinguished candy men
and women. But Wonka is a hired one since Wonka was spied
for his candy. Mr. Wonka was so mad. He gathered all the workers saying, I'm sorry, we all must go home. And then he closed the gates of the factory. Forever.
And Mr. Wonka still makes candies. I can smell them on my way to school.
Yes, but no one comes in and no one goes out. Shadow workers.
Maybe the undead. Who knows?
Okay, Dad. You'll have to be Grand George.
Here you are, Dad. Here's your cabbage soup.
I thought we were paying you.
They wait outside Charlie's house every day with a shiny nickel apiece to buy a local bar. The local candy man, the only kid with no nickel, is Charlie.
Look, it's the candy man!
The candy man!
What you gonna get? Hey, Charlie, help me get something out. I got a nickel.
You already have a sucker. Shouldn't you finish it first?
I can't help it. I love candy. All candy. Chocolate, caramel, jawbreakers, suckers.
Stop it! You're making my mouth water!
Read what it says.
Mr. Willy Wonka has decided to allow five children to tour his factory. The lucky five.
The paper's a day old. I wonder if any of them have been found. How exciting.
Charlie.
Can you imagine winning?
Going to the factory?
Meeting the Cilantro?
See for yourself all those undead zombie workers?
Eating a lifetime supply of chocolate?
Eating a lifetime supply of chocolate?
1 o'clock already? Charlie, you better hurry. You'll be late for school. It's back to the twist and turn of the jig pretty fast for me. Goodbye, Mr. Bucket.
Charlie, remember, we may be starving, we may be poor, but the Bucket family always thinks positive. Write that in purple ink, Charlie. Purple ink.
So Mr. Bucket was off to the toothpaste factory, while little Charlie Bucket was off to school. But on the way, Charlie heard some exciting news.
Did you hear? The first golden ticket has been found.
Already? When?
Just now. Look.
This is Phineas Trout. What? A remote TV link to Frankfurt, Germany. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Over 550,000 Wonka bars are being sold by the hour. First golden ticket has been found. Here's the sign up. Mr. Gloop, do you have a word?
Your name is Gloop. G-L-O-O-P. He's main Kleiner Lepian Augustus.
Tell us how you found the ticket.
Oh, yeah, I just knew my little sausage bossage Augustus would find this golden ticket. He stole the candy fanny. That would be almost impossible for him not to find one. In fact, you could say we've been training him ever since a little pudgy was born.
Training?
Oh, yeah, for Ungati as much as Augustus, he would have to be trained morning to night eating all kinds of foods.
I had my factory girl stop shelling nuts and start shelling chocolate wrappers.
Daddy, that hideous supporter said my name on one of my television. Can you get him fired?
For you, dear. Anyway, after days of shelling chocolate, we found a blasted golden ticket. I gave the lucky winner the finder of the ticket. I later take the
Bucket family went about from morning till night with a horrible rumbling in their tummies. Little Charlie felt it worst of all. But once a year, Charlie got a very special treat.
Surprise! Happy birthday, Charlie!
Here you go. Happy birthday, Charlie, my love. It's from all of us.
Go on, open it.
But is it some Wibble scraps just for all the light?
Best of them all, real Wibble, carefully whipped at 2700 RPMs for precisely 62.3 seconds.
Well, that's that. Who wants a piece?
We wouldn't dream of it, Charlie.
Come on, Dad. Have a piece. You deserve something special after losing your job.
What? It's not true. That's not funny, Charlie. Tell me it's not true.
We'll starve.
It is true.
And no, we'll not starve. Now, what kind of party is this? Let's splurge a little. Turn on the radio.
Mr. Bucket's right. What's a little more electricity? Charlie, go plug in the radio.
Really? This is the best birthday ever!
We interrupt the orphan and radio hour to bring you this important news flash. A third golden ticket has been found in Snellville, Georgia.
Can it, Mama? You kept your gun as much as I do.
On TV.
in freezing, bitter snow. Charlie, where's your coat?
I haven't got a coat.
Here, take this. You'll freeze to death.
Thanks.
Oh, Charlie, would you grab that last case of nut crunches for me?
Sure.
Don't want to freeze.
Oh, I think you dropped this coin.
What's this? It's not mine. Here, take it home to your folks.
You think I should? I should put up a notice.
No. It's probably been buried in the snow for weeks. Take it. And take this too for being such a good kid.
Really?
Really? Really, you look like you're starving.
Mmm, it's so good. A perfect blend of Belgian dark chocolate and New World Light. And a subtle overtone of Moroccan espresso. Oh, he's a genius. I should really get headed to school. Thanks for the candy. Can I just have one more? I promise I'll pay for it.
Okay. The boss is pretty strict about inventory. I give you another one, though, if I could. What'll it be, Charlie, by the way?
Well, I think I'm gonna share this one with the family. Grandpa Joe likes the Whipple Scrumptious Fudge Mall Delight, but Grandma Josephina likes the Nutterific.
Then you should get the Scrumptious Delicious Nutterific Totally Twisted Combo Bar. Just out. Here you go. I know you want to take it home and share with your folks and all, but you might as well take a little taste, you know, to make sure it's not bad.
On the one hand, you are just a bar of chocolate, no different from the rest. On the other hand, you're the superstar.